Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series on the Edison 1878 tinfoil phonograph. Well, I did some adjustments, and we're going to do a quick experiment with the tinfoil tape to see if it's made any difference. So I'm trying to find a starting point for this stylus. So what I did was adjusted the stylus so it's just touching. You just hear it coming into this groove, and then nothing all the way across. So I'm just going to see if that made a difference and if it makes a repeatable difference. So now, of course, the difficult part is lining this stuff up on the mandrel. And I don't want it to wrinkle, so let's try that. All right, so plain old aluminum foil duct tape. Sticking it down on the mandrel. Well, I'm already off, I can see that. At least one groove, it looks like. But good enough for this test. And I also really burnished the edges of this tape for the overlap. Try to reduce that really, really pronounced click. All right, so I'm just going to lightly burnish this down to the mandrel with my thumb. Roll this edge over. So I've adjusted the cut, or the depth of the cut. Let's see if it makes any difference. What I'm looking for is clarity in the recording. Secondly, volume. But I want it to make it as clear as possible, and of course, as loud as possible as well. All right, we're in the first groove on the mandrel. Here's a test on aluminum foil duct tape, and I've readjusted the phonograph.
Hello, hello, hello! Old Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to get her poor dog a bone. But when she got there, the cupboard was bare, and so the poor dog had none. Ha, ha, ha!
All right, cranking it slightly faster. So let's rewind to our starting point. Let's see if this has helped with the clarity of the recording. Impressive recording. Let's rewind it and play it again. All right, second playing. It's clear, but adjusting it that much deeper also increased the background noise. So I don't think I really gained anything doing that. Like I said, you can only get so much out of this aluminum foil tape. And it's not perfect, but it sure does work. So I just wanted to see if making a deeper adjustment would make a better recording. It makes a decent recording, but like I said, cutting it deeper just basically made it more background noise. So let me pull this back off of here. It doesn't stick to the mandrel, so that's one nice thing about it. And you can see how thick this stuff is. I mean, this is pretty thick, 3/1 of an inch. So it is pretty tough stuff. Anyway, just wanted to do a test recording, and just to give you some idea of what I've done here. So I adjusted the stylus, so it is just in the center of the groove. Now, as you hear it going across the mandrel, you'll hear it enter the first groove. Hear that? So now it's right in the center all the way across. You don't hear anything. It's not touching the sides. It's not touching the bottom of the groove. All the way across the mandrel, there's absolutely silent. So, like I said, using that as a starting point, remember this tape is 3/1000 of an inch thick, and this stylus is just probably a few microns off the bottom of this groove. So now I've just got to adjust the depth to find out where the optimum point is. And as I said, doing it this way just basically increased the background noise. It didn't really help the recording. And so I'll begin backing the stylus off a bit now and see what works the best, exactly where the stylus needs to be for using this tape. For right now, this tape is working. And I've got 3 rolls of it, and it's $6 a roll. I'll use it until it's all gone. But like I said, I still have other tape coming. I have some copper tape coming and some new aluminum tape coming. But it's going to be really hard to beat the prices on this stuff. I mean, this copper tape, this duct tape is cheap and it's available. So just wanted to document this experiment. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.